invitation says something about a Christmas telethon. What does that mean?
Oh, I know what a telethon is. It's a really long race. I know because my uncle was in one once. He ran forever and ever and ever, and he was number 370. And I was surprised his legs didn't fall off.
Oh, Gabby, that's a marathon. A telethon for people calling in money for a real important call. Everybody knows that.
Well, evidently everyone but Gabby. So, Miss Parker, what are you raising money for? New Xboxes for Sunday school? A candy machine in the hallway? What is it?
Well, Miles, well, those sound like wonderful suggestions. This kind of telethon, is a little bit different. Tonight, we're going to take turns telling the Christmas story. You know, a telethon. This is how it's going to work. Each of you will come up and take a piece of paper on the box, and whatever it says, that's the part of the Christmas story you will tell.
Gabby. which is almost like Gabriel, an angel in the Christmas story.
Breathe, Gabby, breathe.
Okay, where was I? So there were a lot of angels in the Christmas story. The angel that God sent to tell Mary she was going to have a baby, and the angel that told Joseph in a dream not to be afraid of.
Don't forget the angels that came to the shepherds.
That's right, Ethan. Whose piece of paper said shepherd?
That would be me. But something tells me by the time we get done with the gadget on, we will have time for the telephone.
I have an idea. How about you and Gabby tell us the next part of the story together?
I think I may need to help a little bit here. Right before Jesus was born, Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem. The city was so crowded, they had to stay in a palace hall, and that's where Jesus was born.
Oh, Ethan, that was just beautiful. It reminds me of the time we went on vacation and all the hotels were full.
Meanwhile, there
never seen before. They were smart enough to know that it would lead them to Jesus if they had followed. And when they found Jesus, they worshipped him and gave him treasures of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
They really must have been wise to know exactly what to do and where to go.
I'm sure they didn't know everything. In fact, some of the wise people are the ones who have